All right, check this Mustang out. This is a Saleen, right? See the number there, but it's a Saleen Formula One, which it is a one of one car. It's got a custom one off wheel. I'll show you the badge under the hood here. Okay, kind of cool. Yeah, it's just it's got a Vortech on it. A stock ECU deal yet, stick shift car. It's neat. It's just got some different stuff. It's not something you see every day. You know, your typical headers, full exhaust, that kind of jazz. Interior is custom label with the Saleen 351 or S351. The other thing that you'll notice is, there's no door handles. And I'll show you why that is in a second. But yeah, these typically make, these two valve cars, they make somewhere around 220, 230 stock. Stick shift Vortech car on, you know, the 10 pounds or so peak boost will make low 300s typically. So not expecting anything different here. It is just a normal pump gas, like I said, pump gas stock ECU car. Normally I would tune these on SET, but due to some of the additional systems that are in it, some of the wiring between the OBD2 port and the ECU have been hurt, so I'm actually tuning this in binary editor, which I do from time to time, not typically on OBD2 cars, but you know, we have it for situations like this. But yeah, so I'm gonna show you how these doors work a second, and then we'll get rolling on the tune-up. All right, I'm gonna hop in this thing. Kind of hard to see what's going on. In the little screen in the corner is a screen record from my laptop. And what I'm doing, this is steady state, so I've got the dyno locked at 8 mph, and the highlighted cell in the tuning software that's blue is the mass air voltage. So what I'm doing is I'm regulating throttle position to move the mass air voltage up and down, and as I'm doing that, I'm referencing the mass air voltage. It's logging the point on the mass air transfer, which voltage is matching to what airflow, basically. Looking at the wideband reading in the seat next to me and making corrections to the mass airflow value for the voltage that it's currently at with the air-fuel ratio. So if it's, you know, 15:1, I usually add 5-6%. I'm making pretty broad strokes here to get it in the ballpark. Typically that subtracts pretty good. If it's 20% rich everywhere or in the first few cells, it's usually going to be at least that everywhere else. So you'll see I'm grabbing a lot of large area of the mass air transfer and making some pretty large percentage changes. I think I make a 10% and then a 5% change there, try to get the middle of the road stuff just in the ballpark before we start running into those cells. But a little explanation for you on what I've got going on.
got done tuning this, the Saleen Formula One. It's a one of one car. It made 334 to the tire, 349 foot-pounds of torque. Pretty much what we're expecting. I'll move this out of the way so you can see the graph. But it looks pretty good. Your typical centrifugal charger, you know, Vortech in this case. But yeah, it'll be a good daily driver at that power level. Good and reliable and enough power to have a little bit of fun with. So